How did you start being an activist? What was it and when was it?
I started this summer in August, and I sat in front of the Swedish Parliament and I school striked for the climate. And then after that, I have sat every Friday. And so I'm going to continue to do that until Sweden is in line with the Paris Agreement.
And how much support do you get? Do you get noticed when you are not in school and when you're sitting on the steps of the Swedish Parliament?
Yes, I mean, they support me and they support my message, but maybe not the part of me not being at school, but they help me catch up and so on. So they are supportive.
So that's great. So you're not falling behind in your studies. What made you be so passionate about the environment? What was it that sparked that interest in you?
My interest about the climate and the environment began when I was maybe 10 years old. And my teachers in school told me that there's something called climate change and global warming, and it's caused by humans and our behavior. And I thought that sounded very strange, because if that was so, if there was something that big that threatened our very existence, then that would be our first priority. We wouldn't be talking about anything else. But it wasn't our first priority. And I'm the kind of person who doesn't like when people say one thing and then do another thing. And that was the case with climate change. Everyone said that it's the most important issue of all and it's an existential threat. And yet they just carried on like before. And so I started reading about it. And the more I read about it, the more I understood. And once you fully understand the climate crisis, you cannot un-understand it, then you're stuck. You have to do something about it.
Well, you know what? You have unstuck yourself and you've unstuck a lot of people and made them aware of this crisis in a way that they perhaps weren't before listening to you. You made a big splash at COP24 in Poland and you made a big splash at Davos. And I want to play this little clip of you addressing all these world leaders at Davos.
Adults keep saying, we owe it to the young people to give them hope. But I don't want your hope. I don't want you to be hopeful. I want you to panic. I want you to feel the fear I feel every day. And then I want you to act. I want you to act as if you would in a crisis. I want you to act as if the house was on fire.